You gonna film me?
Yeah.
You getting the landscape?
Did you not listen to what I said?
Yeah, I'm doing it now.
Yeah.
You gonna film me? Are you getting the landscape? Or what are we doing over there?
Well, I mean, it's beautiful out here.
Well, forget those people on the bench. You see them on the bench over there?
I do.
Forget them people. It's all about me right now. This is the Jeremiah Show. All right? Wolf Tick Nation.
I'll get them out of the background.
Thank you. Yeah, we don't need them. All right? That's a beautiful background, though. Guys, Wolf Tick Nation, we are at we're in beautiful Hot Springs, Arkansas, at the Northwoods Trail System. Apparently, there's no swimming, no wading, nor fishing on that body of water. But I have seen people swimming in it. And a few weeks ago, I saw a homeboy fishing over there, all right? Homeboy. So I'm going to write a letter. I'm going to bring my fishing stuff next time. One of the two.
What are you, Karen? Get off my hand!
I'm at Lowe's.
Wolf Tick Nation, thank you guys for tuning in to once again another Wolf Tick Videos episode. On today's episode, guys, we bring you to beautiful Hot Springs, Arkansas. We're here at the Northwoods Trail System. We are fixing to hit some trails, but let's talk about what today's episode is all about. We're fixing to do a little real-time review on the Clark C4 CRS, the Clark's Racing. They're four piston hydraulics, all right? The CRS, Clark's Racing Series brakes. Remember, guys, they send us these brakes. We did not pay for them. They didn't pay us. We're just doing a regular real-time review for you. We're going to see what racing brakes have to offer. Are these things heat up? How's the fade going to be? How's the modulation? Are we going to mess with the reach? I don't know. We're fixing to go hit up Ragnarok. We're going to do a little bit of a real-time review. Hopefully get these things nice and hot and see how they perform today. All right, so please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and let's go ride. All right, guys, we're going to do a little brake rotor bedding. Brake rotor bedding on the CRS C4 Clark's rotors and brakes. Now, remember, these rotors and brakes all come as a kit, and the rotors are floating rotors, which I really like floating rotors, but these ones are just a little different, and I'm not sure if that's going to be the... The four piston states that they're automatically adjusting. They automatically adjust. Now, is that because of the little springs? Does anybody know? You know, the springs that go in between the pads? Is that what it means? Or is there some type of bounce back or something in the caliper itself? I don't know. But it just seems like either the rotors are a little off or the pistons are a little off. Because I'll get this thing set to where it's nice and quiet like it is right now. I'll use the brakes. It'll rub a little bit. And then it's like all out of whack. It's really weird. But anyway, we've got the levers here. Now, they don't claim to be one finger. I have a feeling they're going to be, because these things, just mounting them, feel very strong. We're going to go front brake, rear, and the front rotor that this came with is going to be a 180mm floating rotor, stainless steel, and the internal part of the rotor is a... aircraft aluminum, I believe, something like that. And I think Wolfman said that the pads are ceramic, if I'm correct. We're just going to bed these guys in, make sure they're going to stop us really good on Ragnarok, and hopefully these tires do well, because when we try to do that brake review or the fork review, oh my gosh, damn, the tires were terrible, so we had to get those guys swapped out. But we're just gonna keep bedding these guys in. Hopefully they'll do better. All right, guys, bedding process. It was super exciting. We're all done with the bedding process now. We're gonna head down this trail. I think it's like Bear Pass or something like that. We're gonna head down this trail, and we are gonna go get us some Ragnarok. I'm gonna test these brakes out. All right, Dad, love it. Yeah, and this is the back entrance. Back entrance to Ragnarok. I believe we have to climb up a portion of Valkyrie, I think it is. But this is way better, in my opinion, than hitting the Waterworks Trail on that side. Just a little faster. You guys got to see me do my little adventuring escapades through here a while back, if you guys remember the episodes. But we found it. Such a good shortcut. I'm really looking forward to putting this bike to the test. You know, we've got the fork review coming up. It's the RockShox Duty Gold. I got injured and we had to postpone it, but that review's coming up. If you guys remember, this bike does have the Wolftooth Components 2-degree slacker headset that not only has a degree slack in it, but it also adapts a tapered steer tube to a non-tapered head tube bike. As long as you got that 44-44 headset, you can pop one of these guys in. So that Judy Gold right now is actually a tapered fork, and this bike is not a tapered head tube. So pretty cool adapter. But it's gonna be really exciting to put this fork through some tests and also put these brakes through the test, man. I haven't ridden Ragnarok in a while, and right now with these trails, the way we're working out is these trails are super, you know, full of leaves and everything else. So what I'm hoping is we get some good traction with these new tires we threw on here, and these brakes do a good job in stopping us. Bedding process went good. See if there's any water down here. There's a little bit, but looks like we got some rocks. Super steep here. I know we're getting GoPro effect, but we will pass. Some other guys are taking this little trail too. Okay, careful here. Would suck to slip. It's not cold out just yet, but that would suck to be wet and having to go down this trail. All right, guys, I'm going to put you through this. Let's get this climbing out of the way, and we'll see you up at the top of Ragnarok. All right, guys, here we go. We got the Mongoose Switchback Comp. This is the issue with this bike, right? We talked about the seat post tube. It's a 30.8, nice and fatty, but when we go standing room only, check it out. We have got to chop that sucker or put a dropper on this thing immediately. Good news, it is routed for an internal dropper, but that's just such a damn bummer right there. If I go down to Cat's Meow or something today, I might just take the damn thing off. I don't know. Not recommended, but might just ride it a little bit better. But the Clarks did pretty good coming up here. I really like the lever feel. Again, these are advertised as being a two-finger, but I really think we're going to be able to do a little one-finger action today. 180 Clark rotor up front and the 160 in the rear. We got Dreamcatcher here, and we are fixing to hit Ragnarok, guys. Do a little term review. All right, fellas, have fun. We'll see you guys at the bottom. Hey, I gotta unlock this damn fork. I always forget about that. But here we go on the Dreamcatcher. We're gonna be talking about these brakes and seeing how they slow us down. Will they heat up? I don't know. This bike, on the other hand, this thing's become a rattle trap right now. Definitely a rattle trap on the bike. Little one finger, oh, two finger, I'm sorry. We're gonna go the two finger first. Get some movement down this trail. Good little feature here. Nice. Uh-oh. Shoot. Eesh. Dang it. Oh, man. How the hell did that go in there? Oh, man, I messed that camera up. All right. Let's continue. God, this bike is so small. I love the feel of it, but it's definitely getting used to. We're going back to the two fingers. What I'm liking is I'm not even having to do my ABS technique. What's actually working here for me right now is just being super gentle on the brakes, and they're doing really a good job of slowing me down. We're going a pretty good click here, guys. A little rock garden action. Ooh. I'm doing the two finger, and I can feel every bit of modulation with them at the moment. It's really nice. That fork's doing a good job up front, too. Okay, now we're going to switch to the one finger. It's a little bit more comfortable for me. Although they say they're not a one finger, I'm doubting that. Okay. Another great feel when it comes to brakes is the feeling of being able to feel that pad make contact with the rotor. I can feel it ever so lightly without having to completely slam the brakes down, and that's a huge upgrade right there to normal brakes. You know, not necessarily budget brakes, but to all brakes. What I like too is it doesn't sound like there's any chatter. There's no brake movement, no pad movement sometimes what breaks, especially the big fin ones I've noticed, you get a lot of movement in those pads where you go to hit your brake and you'll actually hear a clicking sound like that rotor takes it with you or takes that pad with it almost. These guys here are doing pretty well as far as the quietness goes. Let's see, we're heating these suckers up. You can see the little bit of discoloration there from the bedding in, and I'm not sure if it's... Wow, I mean, they're really not all that hot. They're just kind of warm to the touch. No discoloration yet, but we've definitely been using it. Let's continue here. Mineral oil hydraulic brakes, 4 pistons. I was thinking, when I was talking about adjusting these things and them rubbing on the pads all the time, maybe that's just at really slow speeds or just in the shop, because out here, there's no rubbing whatsoever. It's very nice. Yeah. No rubbing at all. They're self-adjusting, and it's supposed to really help out with pad wear over time. And those fins on the pads are supposed to help out not with air, right? But supposed to help out with dissipating heat. I always thought that they're supposed to suck heat in or suck air in, but they're supposed to dissipate heat. And that's a lot of fin back there. Totally in control. We're gonna do a... Dude, my chain just came off. We're gonna do a brake slam, see if we can do a whoop, see if we can do a little stoppy up here. See if we can do a stoppy here at the end. Yeah. Nice and smooth. Okay. And we're coming towards the end. No brakes until we go for the stoppy. And stoppy time. Oh yes. Okay, we got a little bit of a stoppage action in there. Let's fill this rotor up here and see if we got any heat coming off of it. Okay. I can smell some of that new coming off. Smell a little bit of the new up here, but it smells good. All right, we got that. And this rear? Yeah. Dude, the rear's not even warm. That right there was a super quick run down Ragnarok. Super quick run. We're going to have to go back to Wolfman. Let's talk about these brakes real quick. I mean, what'd you guys think? How about these tires in this bike? Other than the derailment. Ugh. All right. Hey, I'm a fan of the brakes, you know? It's hard to do a brake review and really relay, oh, they're stopping me. You know, you have to come up with a lot of little things to kind of think about and what the audience wants to hear. All in all, my favorite part of these brakes is from... I mean, a few millimeters, really, of pull on the lever, you can feel it making contact with the rotor already. That's my favorite thing with these brakes. And what's nice is it's not like when you get a quarter of the way through, it starts to hit a wall. It's complete modulation and complete control over where you know that pad is making contact with your rotor until you want to go to the wall. It did a stoppy down here, one finger stoppy. I think Clarks has sound themselves a little short. They say these brakes are 2-finger brakes. They're super comfortable with 2 fingers on there. I'm just not a 2-finger guy. Like, I don't like to have less, I like to have as most amount of contact on a grip as possible at all times. So whenever I put 2 fingers up there, it just feels like I'm naked. But these brakes did a great job on the 1-finger department as well. The levers feel great.
So you're saying they're selling themselves short because it could be a 1-finger brake.
Yeah, they're claiming it's a 2-finger brake, which... You know, whatever, but there I think it could be a 1-finger brake. I've just proved on a pretty fast trail. Yeah, I almost went down it just too fast, and I'm really thinking about it, really putting these brakes to the test. And they slowed me down when they needed to slow me down. The calipers and the rotors, I mean, they got maybe lukewarm a little bit. You know, the rear was completely cool, but the front maybe got a little bit warm. You guys could see a little bit of discoloration up there. I was really hardcore going a lot of breakage on the front. And part of that was because this freaking fork was soaking up so much stuff. I had to, like, you know, use my body weight. But, man, all in all, the C4 Clark, it's the Clark's Racing Series. They're 4-piston brakes. You know, we talked to some guys up there at the Cat's Meow, and they were talking about how they have TRPs and how they're, like, double the price of these things. So he's like, man, had I just got an upgrade, I probably would have gotten those things. You know, he asked me how they were. I said, you're going to have to watch the video. All right, guys. So, man, if you're in the shop for some new brakes, check these things out. They're quiet, you know. They don't rattle. There's no movement in there. The whole self-adjusting thing I was kind of talking crap about, saying that it sucks on the bike rack because you take it off the bike rack, you put it on the floor, you tighten up the skewers, they're rubbing. they stop rubbing out here. I think full time, full speed, using them on and off, there's no rubbing.
And so, if they watch initial impressions, see, I don't know how much we showed, but you definitely adjusted them.
I adjusted the crap out of them. But I think Clark's come out with another great product here. I've always been a fan of Clark stuff, and it's nice that these didn't let us down. And I like the floating rotors too, you know. Again, all the self-adjusting stuff, it actually worked like they said. I thought it was going to keep on rubbing. But anyway, the only negative I think I would have on these brakes is when it comes to the lever department. I really wish that they were like the Shimano and some of the SRAM stuff where you put your finger here and it has that little
the little give
or that spring kickback where it gets out of your way and then you can use the brake. But that's about the only negative. These things did great without fading. I was on them a lot. They didn't fade. They felt just as strong when I started from when I came back. I like them, man. But Wolftick Nation, that was another brake review on Wolftick videos. Appreciate you guys watching. Please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, show you boys some love. And if you guys want to get your hands on some of these brakes, this bike, that headset, that fork, this is the Switchback comp, all right? And this is just halfway through the upgrade series. We still got to do a group set on this thing. I'm really looking forward to it because that group set was a little trashy.
I wonder what group set we're going to go with.
I don't know. I got an idea.
All right.
All right, guys. We'll see you on the next episode.
Yeah.